I'm a comic book geek, so for me, this is definitely a dream come true. You know, for a lot of actors, it's a role, it's a beautiful job, and for me, it's something totally crazy. You know, being an actor and then being a Colossus, it's insane in so many ways.
What do you like best about it?
To be like this old school superhero, some sort of like Marvel's response to Superman. And plus, I'm Slavic generally, so I didn't have like that many opportunities to play superheroes, except maybe to be a villain as Kraven the Hunter. But I got the Colossus, so Colossus is my Academy Award. Silver one.
Coming back to the second one, was it different the second time around coming back to it?
Yes, it was, especially because I did much more regarding CGI facial. So if you can see the difference between the Colossus in the first part, visually even. Because now I did simultaneously at the same time the facial expressions, the CGI, and the voice. Then again, we had like totally like a new director. I started with Tim Miller, and I love Tim Miller. David Leitch brought totally new thing, and we made something really rare, which is like a great sequel. And that doesn't happen, you know, that much. Plus, we have addition with cast, Josh Brolin, who is like amazing. Cable, I love his portrayal of Thanos, by the way. So, plus, I love to say right now that I just did a movie with Brad Pitt and Matt Damon, you know, because we have like those little cameos in the movie. So, anyway, I think that we made such a brilliant sequel, and it's, I want to thank people in UK because I see like that we're like making really great records here. So. It's time to fight dirty, yeah, as I would say in the movie. Well, the thing is, now we're especially focused on this really interesting and amazing relationship between Colossus and Deadpool. So you have this father figure, a brotherly figure, and Colossus who's still trying to make Wade or Deadpool, you know, an X-Men. But then again, he will cross some lines just to you know, to save a friend and to help him, and we really upgraded this relationship, and I'm really proud because Colossus is iconic X-Men, and we didn't have like that much screen time for him in the past. But, well, there were different times. But now with Deadpool 2 especially, we just brought so much of Colossus, and people love it so, so much. And then again, you'll see a lot of Piotr in the future.
Well, what do you think about the whole Juggernaut thing for the movie, because that was a big surprise. No one knew this was coming.
Yeah, and I had to be quiet and like not say anything about the anthology fight, like the comic book anthology, which made me so happy. And I love the way Juggernaut looks. You know, the CGI was perfect. And you know, for me as a fan, that's a fight that I was, you know, wishing for. And the way we did it in the end, it's really amazing. Well, it's not up to me to say, but I see the fans are like totally crazy about it. The whole Colossus role in this movie is so huge and so important. And, you know, having this, that was always my dream, to play someone that can, you know, come as a cavalry in the end and, you know, save his friend. That's one of the things that I always loved. And now I have this chance to do it and, you know, go to Juggernaut as, pick on someone your own size, and then the fight goes. So I'm geeking out when I'm talking about it, because sometimes I just don't realize that I'm the one, you know. I'm so in love with that thing, and it makes me so happy. And I've seen movie like 5 or 6 times, and I still didn't have enough, you know. It's still not making me like bored, or, you know, I just find out I'm in the movie, I'm finding so many new things, and there's like so many little hidden treasures in the movie, which is really rare. But Deadpool can do that. It's like totally different genre. It's something that's, you know, that's why, you know, when they say expect the unexpected, I think this is the only movie that really is, you never know what's going to happen. You know, in Infinity War, you can kind of, you know, think and know what will happen, and it's a beautiful movie. But in Deadpool, come on. Just talk about Vanisher. Come on, man! Like,
with the kind of Marvel Fox buyout now, would you like to see Colossus turning up in more of the kind of expanded MCU stuff?
Well, as a geek, of course. Come on, it's MCU, and it's home. It's homecoming in so many ways. Of course, there's studio politics and, you know, money talks. But generally, of course, you would love to see, you know, Colossus and Wolverine joining Avengers, fighting Thanos, or, you know, it's something that, you know, DC has like their own universe together. We still have like, you know, a little bit of chop, whatever, how I say that. But I would like to see, then again, like Silver Surfer joining the Avengers. And that's one, like, I haven't seen him in a while. And that's one of the, for me, one of the best characters of all time.
Fantastic Four movie.
But, yeah. Well, yeah.
I liked it.
Get out.
That someone that you want Colossus to fight?
Thanos, definitely. Well, just to go against. Yeah, but you know, this was the thing that I was waiting for my whole life, generally, and especially as a geek and as an actor. This is the fight that's, as I said, anthology fight, Colossus Juggernaut. That's Uncanny X-Men 103, that, you know, famous cover with no one can stop Juggernaut. So we stopped him for a while. You saw him getting out from the pool, yeah. But the thing is, I don't know really what's the next step. There's X-Force thing, as you can see in the end of the movie. I'm not spoiling it right now because it's already out, so I can talk. I hope so. Yeah.
And obviously, you've got your sister's appearing as a character. Colossus' sister's appearing as a character in the New Mutants.
Yes.
I'd like to see it kind of getting together and doing like the Death in the Family type storyline.
That would be beautiful, especially Magik is an amazing character, and there is like really amazing relationship between Colossus and Ileana, Piotr and Ileana. And she's portrayed by Anya Taylor-Joy. She's a wonderful actress. So I think it would be beautiful to see them together on the screen, and with these Deadpool things so expanding and making so much money and making, you know, fans love the movie. I think that we will connect. I think she's now in New Mutants, which is, yeah, it's postponed. It's coming out next year. But I think that will be a beautiful thing to have, like, brother and sister finally together on the screen.
Any news on X-Force at all?
Well, the success is making all these things, you know, coming closer and closer. Of course, I'm not like, I really don't know anything about, I have like 4-picture deal as Colossus, but you know, there is so many great things because Deadpool is making this kind of a success, which nobody expects. Even like with the first part that did this phenomenon. Now the sequel is doing really amazingly well. So, you know, it's gonna be a lot of things. So it's just the question because, you know, the Fox needs to decide which is the next one. We have X-Men coming, Dark Phoenix is coming, and New Mutants. But I think there are some talks that, you know, in the end of this year, we'll know which one will come first. Deadpool 3, if it's going to happen, or X-Force, or you never know what's going to happen. But just let's enjoy, like, this Deadpool 2 thing right now.
There was a scene where you had the X-Men cast and they slowly closed the door. It's like, did you actually get to meet them?
No, unfortunately. That was, and I'm so sorry. Yeah, I hate it because I would love to meet them. But, you know, that's brilliant thing. I knew about it because it's in the script. So I was thinking, are they going to get them or that's going to be just one of them? So they shot it before and yeah, it's it's a beautiful thing. It that's something that, you know, when you watch the first one and then when he's complaining because there is nobody there, now you have everybody like sitting and just closing the door and he's like, and he doesn't see them again. So it's, and it's great that, you know, X-Men family and X-Force, because it's like X franchise anyway. So it's really good that everybody is so, how to say that, we all function as a family generally. Like it's just like MCU has. On the other side, we have as an ex family. So whoever I see and I didn't know them before, everybody's, oh, yeah, you're mine, or something like that, which I cannot say to, for example, Infinity War guys. But everybody who's ex franchise, they like kind of feel the same.
Was it a slightly different dynamic filming the second one, given that the first one was kind of seen as a bit of a risk, whereas after the success of the first one, was it kind of a different dynamic filming?
But it's still, the sequel is always a risk in so many ways, because, you know, you never know, and people will be, you know, comparing with the first one. But, you know, we have like a new director, we had like a little bit bigger budget. It's still not the big as the other superhero movies, but then again, we had new characters and we really have a master of action movies, which is David Leitch. So you can see the action scenes are so brilliant. And then again, you have master of improvisation, Ryan Reynolds, who owns this character. Like, no, I don't think that maybe like Robert Downey Jr., but like the way he's portraying the character, like that's him. And I don't think that there is any actor in the world that can portray Deadpool as good as Ryan Reynolds. That guy is like so quick, so, you know, so clever and so funny. And, you know, you just, when you work with him, he's like always making so many jokes and giving you ideas, even like he's working on his character, but he's always like, okay, let's do this. Let's try to say this, or, you know, and then you just start laughing and, you know, you make something much better than you thought it's going to be. And he's always, you know, giving you that, this kind of a, he believes in you and he gives you support so you can really experiment and you can, that's why we have like so many of the lines that I'm doing in the movie, they were not in the script. He's just like doing lines with me and we're like working. He's like, okay, maybe you can say this here now. And then I go, okay, we were making so many jokes regarding the juggernaut, you know, like, you know, he was like, come on, say juggernaut, you know, like, you know, Russian kind of thing. So it's like so many crazy, funny things that you know, we did during the process. And he's like, even like sending me like sometimes like an email. Oh, wait, Stefan, think about, what do you think about, you know, and he tapes himself and gives me an idea, you know. So, you know, it just came to him like while eating or, you know, doing something. So that's the guy who's so focused. And that's why Deadpool has this kind of success, because the power that Ryan Reynolds has as, you know, not just for himself, but for a whole team. It's really unbelievable. It's really rare.